On September of 2020, we arrived to our land. It was still a really hot summer, and we didn't have running water or electricity. But when we arrived, we came with our four hands and a big tree. The land we found was abandoned for many years. No animals ever pastured on it, and nobody really grew any type of food or planted many trees. The trees we found were mainly tiny olive trees, planted more than 100 years ago, but they were never really cared of. The project we had in mind to transform this land was quite overwhelming for the two of us alone, so we needed to start somewhere, and we chose to start working in the top part of the property, the smaller one with an area of around 300 square meters. Working in this part first allowed us to learn more about the place, the climate, changes of seasons, and what type of soil we had. But besides learning by observation, we learned by doing. Against all odds and lack of machinery, we started the works. The first thing we did was to create an organic vegetable garden, and later on, continue planting the first trees. This way, we could not only get food for ourselves, but also create new life and an ecosystem around us. By doing so, these past 2 years, we developed many new skills, and we were also able to learn from the land and the mistakes we made. Which brings me to this day, the day when we started the most important task to create a food forest in the bigger part of our land. During the past 2 years, one of the most important lessons we learned is that lack of water was as damaging to the plants as the excess of it. Some parts of our current garden get flooded during rainy season, and we cannot grow anything during the fall and winter months in those areas. On top of that, we have already lost a few of the trees we planted due to stagnant water in our compacted soil, which rotted the roots of the young trees. For this reason, it was important to stop and redirect the excess flow of water down the hill, to avoid floods in the garden area, and also not to kill the future trees we plant. Once the trench was finished, the next step was to clean all the dirt we dug from the trenches and use it to level the area of the garden that was much lower, in order to avoid the water getting stagnant in the middle of it. The soil was really wet and muddy, mainly because all the water that flows from our hill and our neighbor's properties ends in here. The reason why we chose this lightweight mini excavator to do the job was simple, because it was the only machine we had access to do this job, and because doing it by hand didn't make any sense for us now that we have access to a machine that could do the physical job for us. While I was cleaning everything as best as I could, Pepe continued getting everything ready in order to mark the position of the future garden. We also removed the bigger rocks we found. Once the soil gets drier, we can start working on it. First, we will need to superficially loosen it to give some structure to it, and later on add compost to give nutrients and start building a new soil. But for that, we first had to wait a few weeks, since at this point everything was muddy. is official. I'm going to start planting the potatoes today. This past 2 weeks I was able to fix 2 of the garden beds that I have been working on. It took much longer than expected because they were full of rocks. I think I empty like 10 wheelbarrows more or less. Because next week is going to be raining, I wanted to plant the first potatoes and onions on it. I'm going to start with 3 varieties for 2 reasons. The first one is because these are the late potatoes that I have, so it's going to take them longer to start harvesting. And then because 2 of them are already sprouted, so it was about time to put them in the soil. At this point, I started to feel a bit down because the plans of the beautiful garden I envisioned were not really coming together, beside all the hard work I was putting to make it happen. I was waiting for a local farm to bring a batch of compost and hay to cover the first potatoes and onions. I waited for weeks, and I couldn't really wait any longer if I wanted to have potatoes and onions to store for the next year. If my own doubts were not enough, all the neighbors who passed by the area thought that I was just wasting my time with this garden, that in their opinion, it had zero chance to survive. But this situation felt familiar because we have been here before. I believe every hard situation I had to go through in my life prepared me for this exact moment. Sometimes things in life don't come as easy as we would have thought, but trusting in myself and doing everything I had in my own hands to make it happen was all I could do at this moment. And I wasn't going to give that power away. Today, after many months of work, I can share with you all the launch of my farm-to-table online masterclass, a more than 1 hour long class where I explain and share everything that I have learned during the past years to create the abundant garden we currently have. And I have been able to launch it thanks to Squarespace, the platform that I used to launch my farm-to-table garden guide last year, and this month the launch of my masterclass. Their beautiful and functional templates allowed me to do so seamlessly. While they handle the logistics, I'm able to focus in my garden and creating new content. They will help you stand out with a beautiful website, thanks to the many different features they offer. If you would like to start your own website or online store, go to squarespace.com/EugeniaDiaz for a free trial and a 10% off your first order of a website or domain. I will leave all the links in the description box and look forward to seeing you creating beautiful things.